To another session of Tony Talks right here on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, Tumblr, Twitter, my fans only, all at I Am Tony 215. And this is officially the first Tony Talks of the year 2020. We left 2019 in the past yesterday. Literally yesterday. Many people always ask me, oh Tony, you know, can I date this nature? And oh Tony, can I date that nature? And so, of course, someone has asked me, Tony, can a Scorpio date another Scorpio? And so today, on Tony Talks, I'm gonna answer that question. Can a Scorpio date another Scorpio successfully? Let's talk about that. I'm like, I don't know, but the dating guru. Somehow, some way that has happened. So many people contact me and ask me about relationship dynamics based on constellation mapping. And constellation mapping is what I teach. I teach constellation mapping to help people not only find their way in life, and not only to help people find out more information about themselves, but also to help people find love. And let me just first say that anyone can date anyone, and you can actually be successful at it. The only complication is it's gonna be a lot of work. It's gonna be a lot of extra work. And in my opinion, it's gonna be a lot of extra unnecessary work. So can a Scorpio date another Scorpio successfully? Based on constellation mapping says that a Scorpio and another Scorpio in an intimate relationship will only cheat on each other. And the only way that infidelity will not take place is if that is an open relationship. Because both natures are water natures, and as I teach, water natures need to be held. It's going to be a lot of relationship dynamics that are going to be missing. The problem that occurs when two natures under the same house, and in this case you have two Scorpios, you have two water natures under the same house of water. The problem is when you have two natures under the same house, of course they're going to get along. Of course, they're gonna probably agree on a lot of common things. That's because they practically see the world the same way. They practically move in the world the same way. They are of the same nature. No, they're not exactly the same because they come from different family dynamics. You know, they probably come from different, life environments and so forth. But at the end of the day, they will share a lot of common behaviors. And so when these two natures get together, they coexist so well together that the two people will mistake this as a green light to have an intimate relationship in hopes that they'll stay together long term and they'll actually be happy. But the truth is, it won't always be that way. Yes, the two natures will get along and they may have some great sex, but there will be some things missing in that relationship. And because of these things that will be missing, infidelity will creep in. And it's not that these two individuals are bad people. It's not that they're whores and they're hoes and they're being, you know, thoughts. It's not that. It's just when you are of the water nature, you need to be hailed. Whether you're a Pisces, whether you're a Cancer, whether you're a Scorpio, it is in your nature to be hailed. Just like water needs to be hailed, you need to be hailed. And another water nature just can't do that for you. I know, because my last relationship was with a Scorpio, and this was before I knew constellation mapping. This was before I even started teaching constellation mapping as a tool to help people find love, and using constellation mapping as a tool in dating. It was a very calm relationship. We got along very well, you know. We liked a lot of the similar things. We had a lot of this most, you know, like similar behaviors, which caused an issue. Because, you know, let's face it, Scorpios, they're secretive. We don't tell everything, you know. We can have something going on and you won't even know, and you could be sitting right next to us. You know, that's just our nature. We want to know about you, but you don't need to know everything about us. So when you put these two natures together, when it comes to communication, disaster. There is no communication, or there is not enough communication in that relationship. Eventually, we ended up in a open relationship. And even though the water nature, you know, can conform to an open relationship, it is really not in the water nature to engage in open relationships. We can do it. We can do it and still find some happiness in it. But at the end of the day, we would really prefer one-on-one. But I have dated a Cancer, complete disaster, same issue, communication, out the window, done, it's just no good whatsoever. And I have dated a Pisces. Me being part of a Capricorn nature, me and the Pisces, we did very well. But when you put a Pisces and a Scorpio together, it's really the same thing. You might as well be dating a Cancer or another Scorpio. The communication sucks. The communication is horrible. It's just out the fucking window, you know? Because everybody's just too quiet, too secretive, too watchful, and just not saying enough. And a Scorpio and another Scorpio date and be successful at it. Yes, it would just be a lot of exhausting work. Just get with your perfect match, the person that complements your nature, and I assure you that you will have a totally different outcome. But until then, people, this has been another session of Tony Talks right here on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, Tumblr, Twitter, my fans only. And I am still on the fence about my fans only, because yes, I do have political aspirations because of the expectations of my fans only. It may not be a good fit for me politically. But anyways, this has been a session of Tony Talks. Please don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please don't forget to follow me on Instagram, Facebook, Tumblr, Twitter, all of that, Tony215. And until then, people, welcome to 2020. It's January 1st. I love you. Peace.